Hey guys, welcome. So this tutorial has been a long time coming, and honestly I have been a little bit afraid of making a tutorial for this build because it's, yeah, I think it's in a lot of ways it's much more complex and difficult to translate into a tutorial compared to other builds I made tutorials for. And for this build it's much more, I don't know, it has a lot of quirks, and when designing it I didn't make it easy for myself. And that is because I never knew I had to make a tutorial for it, so yeah, that makes sense. Okay, so just a little backstory. This build was conceived back before I even started the channel, and it was actually an adaptation of the Cold Tower from the first video I made. And it was around the same time I learned about World Edit, and with that tool I could do so much more. I could scale up the build and just go nuts and create this massive cathedral. And after creating my YouTube channel, I knew that at some point I would want to use this build in some kind of video. But the size of it alone, just, I wasn't going to create a time-lapse at that point in time. Instead, I decided to incorporate the build into some kind of story. And I found that the horror genre was very fitting for this kind of build. And because of the complex nature of the build, I've decided to do a voiceover for this video. It might make it easier for some of you to understand how everything is put together. So yeah, let's try and see if it works, hopefully, and see if it's a better method, because yeah, it is a weird build in many ways. Okay, so we're gonna build in an isolated world, but I will post a seed for an updated seed actually. So the world you're seeing here is actually from a newer seed. I will show you how to build it in the exact same location. As always, we will build a clean version of the build. What you see here is two versions. The one on the left is the clean version, and on the right you have the textured version. I will probably show you how to texture in the last video in this series, but in my opinion, if you don't want to, you don't need to do that much texturing, because it's one of those builds that has enough detail to work quite well without. But yeah, that is totally up to you, and in the end I will probably redo the texturing, because I mean, it's fine and a lot of it works quite well, but some of it could be improved, especially the foundation part. I've also taken this as an opportunity to do some improvements to the ceilings and some other stuff too. In this video we're going to build the foundation. To make it easier, we're going to build a simplified version of the foundation and then add more and more detail. If you want to, you can use stone bricks for everything. You don't have to use deep slate bricks like I did here. I just wanted to make it easier to visually separate the foundation and the pillars. But if you do want that gradient, I'll suggest using deep slate for the foundation and then stone bricks for the rest. And then you can work in the texturing later. Here are the dimensions of the foundation. And the entire build is symmetrical. And the choir and transepts are actually identical too. So just as a side note, when I post these dimensions, they're meant as measurements. So as you see here, I've tried to illustrate what I mean by that. The outer corner blocks are counted twice, and the inner corner blocks aren't counted at all. The easiest way to think about it is measurements for the white lines, actually. If you want to build in the same seat I did, the red block should be at these coordinates in this seat. This particular foundation is 14 blocks tall, for those who don't want to use the seed and build with the exact coordinates I used before. During the tutorial, you'll see me place temporary blocks, so it's easier to see the distance between each element. And you can make all the volumes hollow if you want to. Okay, let's begin. Thank you. extend the foundation till it meets the ground. Now repeat this on the other side. Thank you. Build this buttress at each pillar as shown here.
Thank you.
Repeat everything you just did on the other side. Thank you. repeat this on the left and right transept, as shown here. And that's about it for this episode. And for this year, actually. It has been such a great year, and I'm so happy for all the support. I can't wait to make new videos and new builds. I have so many plans, so many great things I want to make. So see you next year. Peace, love, and Merry Christmas.